Ooh, what's up everybody? Andrew Mahon here with Tricky Jim at Full Grip Games. A new battle style just dropped. Fusion Arts is the name of the upcoming Japanese Pokemon trading card game set featuring brand new Pokemon Fusion. Like Single Strike Pokemon and Rapid Strike Pokemon before them, Pokemon Fusion have ways of interacting in battle that make them more powerful when they are played together. This new set looks like it's going to be amazing. It features a new Mew VMAX as well as this Lifesavers dispenser. So let's check it out. Fusion Arts has officially been revealed. It's a new battle style mechanic. We're here on PokeGuardian.com, who has got the news and the translations and that beautiful Mew pack art featuring Genesect and Dragapult and Dreepy. Wow, I mean, it seems as if Pokemon just does not miss. They just keep pumping out incredible idea after incredible idea. We had Charizards, we have the Eeveelution VMAXs, we had Rayquaza, and now we've got a set with Mew as the mascot. I mean, my goodness. I have a feeling that this will also be a very popular set. Mew VMAX. This Mew VMAX looks amazing, and it's super cool as well. It's got 310 hit points, a Psychic-type Pokemon. Weak to Dark. Seems as if Psychic-type Pokemon in 2021 are pretty much all weak to Dark these days. And this Mew being weak to Dark, is this the first Mew that's ever been weak to Dark? I am curious, because usually Mewtwo and Mew and those guys are all weak to Psychic. So very interesting. It does seem as if they are kind of officially transitioning that Psychic weakness away to Darkness type. And Mew has got a minus 30 resistance to fighting and a free retreat cost. It's got a couple of amazing attacks as well. Cross fusion for two colorless energy. You get to choose one of your benched fusion Pokemon's attacks and use it as this attack. Mew has a long and glorious history of copying other Pokemon's attacks. Let's take a look. Of course, there is Mewtwo and Mew Tag Team GX with its Perfection ability, allowing it to copy any of your Pokemon GX or EX attacks in your discard pile or on the bench. One of my favorite Mews is Mew from Fates Collide. It has the Memories of Dawn ability, which allows it to use any of your basic Pokemon's attacks on the bench. This card was fantastic in Night March, one of my favorite decks of all time. And who could forget about Mew EX from Dragons Exalted with the versatile ability, which allows it to copy the attack of any Pokemon in play. It's crazy to think this card is over a decade old at this point. I think this Mew Prime from Triumphant might be one of the most beautiful Mew cards ever printed. An amazing artwork and a very cool Pokebody Lost Link, which allows it to copy the attacks of any Pokemon in either player's Lost Zone. And just when I thought I had run out of Mews that copy things, there's actually a bunch more. It turns out Mew has been copying things since Mew was even conceived as a Pokemon. So it's only fitting that the new Mew VMAX can copy any of your fusion Pokemon's attacks from the bench, and for two colorless energy means that this Mew could fit into any type of deck. Mew VMAX also has the Max Miracle attack for two psychic energy, which is not affected by any effects on your opponent's active Pokemon, meaning that it goes straight through Decidueye's Deep Forest Camo ability, as well as Altaria's ability, which does the same thing but has a different name. Mew VMAX evolves from Mew V Fusion. This Mew has more attitude than any Mew I've ever seen printed before. This thing looks super cool. It's got two attacks. Energy Mix for one psychic energy allows you to attach an energy from your deck to one of your fusion Pokemon then shuffle your deck. We've seen this kind of attack see some play in standard format with Jirachi GX, right? And Star Search attack for just one energy. Mewtwo and Mew decks have been using attacks like that all season. So Energy Mix, pretty good attack. Very similar to that Jirachi GX. And then Psycho Jump for a psychic and a colorless energy does 70 damage, and you may shuffle this Pokemon and all cards attached to it back into your deck. There's something in the way that Hoopa looks at me that makes me very uncomfortable, but you know what? This Hoopa V is awesome. It's got 220 HP, is a fusion Pokemon, and it's got an ability and an attack. Its ability, Double-Faced, reads, while this Pokemon is in play, it is both psychic and dark type. With all of these abilities that make Pokemon dual type coming out lately, it makes me wonder if Pokemon is killing off the dual type mechanic and replacing it with these dual type abilities. I'm not gonna lie, I really liked the dual type mechanic where a card was two different colors. I thought that was sweet, so I'm hoping that maybe one day they bring that back. But this Hoopa being both dark and psychic type is pretty sweet because it means you can play it in your Eternatus VMAX deck and have a psychic type Pokemon on your bench alongside Eternatus, which is usually something you can't do. So that is pretty cool. Its attack, Shadow Impact, for two dark and a colorless, does 170 damage, and you have to put three damage counters on one of your Pokemon. So one of the cool things that this Hoopa allows in your Eternatus deck is it allows your Eternatus to hit for psychic type weakness, which is something the deck couldn't otherwise do, and 170 damage means that you're going to be one-hit KOing any Pokemon in the game that's weak to psychic, like Urshifu VMAX. And did I mention that it's weak to grass? Yeah, this card's going to be really good against Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX, not only giving Eternatus VMAX decks a way to hit Urshifu VMAX for weakness, but also denying that Urshifu a weakness to fighting in return. This card is really, really cool. Genesect V. We got any Genesect stands out there? Genesect brings me way back. Wow. Virizion Genesect. What an incredible deck from the Plasma Blast set. We haven't quite seen a Genesect card as powerful as Genesect EX since Plasma Blast. This Genesect V has 190 hit points. It's a fusion Pokemon as well. It's got an ability and an attack. Its ability, Fusion System, reads, once during your turn, you may draw cards until you have as many cards in your hand as you have fusion Pokemon in play. I think that this ability is super cool. Now, it only gets better the more you set up. So it's interesting because it'll probably help you to draw more cards at the end of the game, but won't help you to draw too many cards at the beginning of the game. If you're playing a fusion type deck, then I think Genesect V just makes a lot of sense to include in your deck. And it's got an attack, Techno Buster, for two metal and a colorless, does 210 damage, and this Pokemon can't attack during your next turn. Got some serious Brave Blade vibes to it. I think that this Genesect V is going to be an auto inclusion in many fusion decks. Elsa's Radiance allows you to choose up to two of your fusion Pokemon in play, and for each Pokemon you chose, search your deck for a fusion energy card and attach it to that Pokemon. I like this supporter because it searches energy from the deck. That's great. It accelerates energy to two different Pokemon. That's also great. I think that this Elsa's Radiance card is going to be phenomenal in fusion type decks, and I think that fusion decks are probably going to rely very heavily on this card to juice energy into play. Chili, Silent, and Cress. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't know that Silent had any friends, okay? Silent is the only one that I've ever heard of. Back in the day, Silent used to fetch you three energy from the deck and put them into your hand. I'm not gonna lie, I don't know who these red and blue haired dudes are, okay? All I know is Silent, the green haired guy, who gets you 3 energy. Apparently, Chili, Silent, and Cress is a fusion supporter. It allows you to search your deck for up to 3 fusion Pokemon and put them into your hand. This is a cool supporter because it doesn't only get you basic fusion Pokemon to help you set up your deck, it can also get you fusion evolutions, fusion Pokemon VMAX. I think it's a nice, versatile supporter for fusion decks. Power Tablets is a fusion lifesaver type thing that get dispensed out of this tube with a Pokeball on top of it. Very cool. Anyways, it's like Fusion Electro Power. It's an item card that reads, during this turn, your fusion Pokemon's attacks do 30 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon before applying weakness and resistance. Well, we all remember how amazing Electro Power was. Electro Power was so good that it made Vikavolt V a pretty much unstoppable deck for about a month that they were standard legal together. It made Pikachu and Zekrom Tag Team GX the powerhouse attacker that we all knew it to be for that first year it was legal. And we all thought that Lightning Pokemon would fall apart without it. That's how powerful Electro Power was. It was just played as an instant four of in all lightning type decks. So I do highly anticipate that this, what, fusion candy? Power tablets will be seen in just about all fusion type decks, because if you play 2 power tablets in a turn, that means your fusion Pokemon's attacks are doing 60 more damage that turn. If you play 3, that's 90 more damage. 4, it's 120 additional damage, and boosting your damage output in the Pokemon trading card game has pretty much always been good. There's a new fusion energy as well that can only be attached to fusion Pokemon. It's a rainbow energy, just like the ones that Rapid Strike Pokemon and Single Strike Pokemon have access to, except instead of preventing a status condition, it prevents all effects of your opponent's abilities done to the Pokemon this card is attached to. So that is super useful. Having ability protection is very nice. Going to protect your Pokemon from Galarian, Zigzagoon's Headbutt, Tantrum, and things like that. Meloetta is a fusion Pokemon with 90 hit points. Has the Melodious Echo attack, which does 70 damage for each fusion energy card attached to your Pokemon in play. So if you have 4 fusion energy in play, going to be doing 280 damage for just 2 energy. But how easy is it really going to be to get 4 fusion energy in play? And then there is Fusion Dragapult. This is the second Dragapult ever printed. It's a fusion type Pokemon, which is super sweet. And it's got 2 attacks. Fusion Assault for 1 psychic energy does 30 damage for each of your fusion Pokemon in play. So if you got 6 fusion Pokemon in play, you're gonna be doing 180 damage for just 1 energy. And then Speed Attack for a psychic and a colorless does 120 damage. Evolves from Dracloak. Evolves from Dracloak. And then there's also a very cute little Dreepy. Love it. Gorbis is a new fusion Pokemon with the ability Rapid Strike Canceler. You heard it here, folks. Rapid Strike Pokemon are canceled. The ability reads, your opponent's Rapid Strike Pokemon in play have no abilities. Take that, Rapid Strike Octillery. Huntail has the ability Single Strike Jammer. Your opponent's Single Strike Pokemon's attacks cost 1 colorless more. It's like Headringer. If any of you old heads have been playing the Pokemon trading card game since the X and Y block, Headringer was a tool card you could put on your opponent's Pokemon. The Pokemon card most likely to be carried off by your opponents were those Team Flare tools, because you actually attached them to your opponent's Pokemon. So that's pretty neat. Single Strike Jammer makes it so your opponent's Single Strike Pokemon's attacks cost 1 colorless more. That is incredibly frustrating to play against. I actually really like that Huntail's ability, but it is a very specific kind of tech against single strike decks, because its attack, Cavernous Chomp, is not very good, right? So you would only play the Huntail in your deck if you were trying to tech against single strike decks. Cards like this make me really wish that Ditto Prism Star was still around, because then it would make it very easy to tech a card like this into your deck Instead, you got to play a whole 1-1 line. But you know what? That's not so bad. Since I've been playing Gym Leader Challenge format, I've grown to love, even adore, 1-1 lines. Yeah, you get them out pretty consistently, turns out. So maybe we see some action from Huntail in the future. Oricurio Fusion. This card just seems absolutely bananas. I don't know if anybody's read this thing. I read this thing. I was waking up. It was like 7 a.m. And I, you know, here we are. Okay, there's new cards up. Let's take a scroll ski through these. What in the world? This Oricurio has got Dripping Passion. Put 5 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. And its ability, Ardent Lessons, your fusion Pokemon in play, take 20 less damage from your opponent's attacks. Like, what? What? The ability just makes you take 20 less. Just period. No, like, no questions asked. You don't have to have a certain amount of fusion Pokemon in play. There has to be no conditions met. You don't have to evolve this thing. You just put it onto your bench, and then all of your fusion Pokemon are now just beefy dudes. This is a phenomenal card. You can't stack it. You can only do one of these abilities per turn. If you could stack it, it would obviously be broken, right? But the fact that you can combo this with tool cards as well, various tool cards that decrease the amount of damage your Pokemon takes or makes your Pokemon's hit points bigger, I think that this Oricurio is absolutely going to be a card that sees play in a lot of fusion type decks, if not all of them. And its attack places 5 damage counters. That is so good. I really think that this Oricurio has some potential. Toxtricity is a very cool Pokemon, and this Toxtricity fusion does not disappoint. It's got 120 hit points, an ability, and an attack. Its ability, Max Downer, reads, if all of your Pokemon in play are fusion Pokemon, each of your opponent's VMAX Pokemon's hit points becomes 30 less. So you could use this Toxtricity to bring the HP totals of your opponent's Pokemon VMAX down, which is pretty good. I do like that. So this really encourages the fusion Pokemon to be built together, which I think makes a lot of sense. They're really kind of leaning into the various battle styles being built together and combining to be played together. And then its attack, Headbolt, just does 90 damage. And the last card, Smeargle. Sorry, Toxel, we're skipping you. All right, Toxel, what do you do, Toxel? Growl. All right, Growl, right? 30 less damage, Mini Bolt. Cool. All right, Smeargle, the last Pokemon we're going to talk about. Smeargle Fusion has got the attack, Discard Sketch. For 1 colorless energy, you get to choose up to 2 Fusion Trainer cards from your discard pile, reveal them, and put them into your hand. It's kind of like Junk Hunt, baby. Let's go. Except only for fusion trainers, and you can get back electro powers, or, you know, the fusion candy, right, with Smeargle, as well as some of those cool fusion supporters. So maybe this Smeargle sees some play as a fusion type support Pokemon. And that's it for Fusion Arts. Thank you so much for watching the video. Let me know, what do you think of the upcoming Japanese Pokemon trading card game set, Fusion Arts, in the comments below. If you like the video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and check out the Twitch stream, twitch.tv/TrickyJim, where I stream live Pokemon trading card game content every single weekday. We've got a super welcoming community over there, and we'd love you to be a part of it. Y'all have a busted day. Peace.